going to show you how to set up a triggered profile for your FieldView PD instrument. By setting up a triggered profile, ValveLink knows when to alert you when a specific event occurs. To begin, open the ValveLink software and open the tag for the instrument you want to set up a triggered profile for. Go to Diagnostics, and then Performance Diagnostics. Click on Triggered Profile. This page will open. This is the input portion of the triggered profile. Here's where you specify your variables. Make sure you have a new data set selected. Now choose your collection variables. When an event occurs, these are the four variables the instrument will collect. I've chosen travel set point, travel, drive signal, and supply pressure for now. Now decide on a collection interval. This is the time interval that the instrument will gather data. Next, you need to decide which event will trigger the collection of data for your selected intervals. By default, it is travel deviation. You can select more than one if you want, but I'm going to leave travel deviation selected. Lastly, for the inputs page, decide how long you want the instrument to record data. The instrument can hold up to 15 minutes of data total, so keep that in mind when you're choosing a record length. When you're done choosing your inputs, go to the Trigger Thresholds tab. This is where you specify what triggers the collection of data. This is how the instrument knows a travel deviation has occurred and then it needs to start recording data. You can change any of these trip points to better suit your process, but I'm going to leave them at the default values. Make sure to click Apply if you make any changes. Now that you are done setting up the triggered profile, I'm going to cause an event to show you how to collect the data. There are a number of different ways you can download the data stored in your PD instrument after an event has occurred. The first way is to look at the multi-tag status. Go to Network, and then to Multi-Tag Status, and then click on All Instruments. I only have one tag at the moment, otherwise I would see all the instruments in this process. Instead of checking each instrument one by one, you can get a general overview of them all at once. You can see there is currently data in this tag's buffer. Double-click on it to open the tag. Now you can start monitoring to check the status, and you can see that the Alert tab is highlighted, signaling a new alert. But we're going to look at the Batch Runner instead. Go to Tools, and then click on Batch Runner. Under Task, find Upload PD or PST/SIS Diagnostics Data. After choosing a tag, clicking Run will download any available data stored in the instrument for you. But I'm going to show you one last way to download the data instead of running the Batch Runner. Go back to Diagnostics, Performance Diagnostics, and then Triggered Profile. In this box, you can see that there is data available in the instrument to read. Click the Read Trigger Data. Once the data is acquired, the graph will appear with the variables collected. You can see that the travel deviations occurred on the timeline. If you need to, you can go to the Notes tab and write down anything about this triggered event for future references. Make sure you save the data by clicking the Save Dataset button. This message will pop up asking you if you want to clear the instrument's data buffer. Clicking Yes allows the instrument to store up to 15 minutes of data again and removes the dataset from its buffer. You can see that this dataset is accessible from the drop-down list from any point in time. Okay, we have successfully set up a triggered profile.